So Christmas is just around the corner. I want to show you guys how you can snowify your PowerPoint templates to look just a little bit more on theme with the holidays. So without further ado, let's get started. What's going on, guys? My name is Stanczak, and if you are interested in anything related to PowerPoint, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. It's free to do. And without further ado, let's get to the tutorial. All right, so as you can see here in this presentation, I went ahead and made it all Christmas themed pictures and then kind of dressed up a little bit. And then also on this slide, you'll see in particular that I added in a bunch of different snowflakes at different sizes for us to play around with. And we're gonna actually animate them and kind of add them into the slide in a nice, clean and professional way, but also fun for the holidays. All right, so on slide one, I see these snowflakes and I'm just gonna kind of click and hold down Control. And then click and drag whatever ones I feel like adding in. So I'm going to add in this one. And then I'll click on this one, add this in here. I'll click on this one, add in that right. Maybe I'll add in here. Then I'll click and drag this one over here. So as a shortcut, while I'm doing this to copy over the snowflakes, is all I'm doing is holding down that control button and then clicking and dragging these snowflakes in order to add them in. All right, so now I'm gonna add in a little bit of a smaller size snowflake. So I'll add this in maybe right here. And then I'll add this one in right here. This one like so, and then this one. And now I wanna add an even smaller snowflake. So I'm gonna add in this one, maybe right there. This one right here. All right, so now there's a lot of snowflakes on the slide. I'm just gonna add in this small section right here and I'm gonna speed it up real quick. All right, so now that I added in all the different snowflakes, what I wanna do next is animate those snowflakes to come in nice and smoothly on the slide. So I'm gonna select this snowflake right here, go to the animations pane, click this drop-down arrow, and click lines. All right, now after I did that, I'm gonna actually shift this snowflake to appear up above, outside of this line. And then I'm gonna shift this red dot. And all I'm doing with this is holding down shift, clicking that red dot, clicking and dragging so that hovers over the original position of that snowflake. And then the green dot is outside of the slide. All right, so now if I go to animation pane and I say with previous, I play this, it's just gonna fall in nice and smoothly. And then what we also wanna do is add in a spin effect because as the snowflake is falling, we also want it to be spinning. So I'm gonna add in the spin effect and make sure you're clicking it from this section right here and not from this section because if you click here, it's gonna get rid of your previous animation that you added. So I'm gonna click down here and then do spin. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in here to effect options and we'll have it spin a full 360. And we'll hit okay, do with previous, and then we'll see it play. All right, so now let's see it play all together. All right, so that goes a little too long, so what I wanna do is maybe shorten it to a minute. And then what we'll also do is we'll do effect options and we'll change the clockwise to be just a half spin. All right, so now let's watch that. All right, so that's a little too short. So we're actually going to increase the duration to match this duration up here. And now let's play it. All right, so another thing I wanna do with this snowflake is I actually wanna add a smooth end. So I'm gonna click this drop-down arrow, do effect options and do a smooth end all the way to 2 seconds. All right, so now let's play it again. All right, so that looks a lot better. We're actually going to probably add in a fade animation to this as well. And we're gonna put that on the top with previous, and then we'll scoot over a delay of 0.25 seconds. So now let's play this again. All right, so now that we finished animating that one snowflake, I now want to mimic the same styling of that animation with all the other snowflakes. And to achieve this, I'm going to use the Animation Painter tool. Now, if you want to have an in-depth tutorial on how to use the Animation Painter tool, I actually covered it in this video right here. So make sure to check that out. But for now, we're going to use the Animation Painter tool to achieve this nice look and feel of snow falling. So what I need to do is I need to select the object that I added all those animations for. Then I'm going to click the animation painter tool. I'm going to double click it. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on all the different snowflakes on this slide. So I'm going to click here, and I'm just going to keep clicking until I have all these different snowflakes selected. And I'm just going to speed this up so you guys don't have to watch me clicking, and then I'll get back to you guys. All right, so now that I've just finished adding in all the different animations for all those snowflakes, I now want to show you guys what this looks like in presentation mode. All right, so now it has a nice snowy feel. I'll play it again, and it looks like snow's falling from the sky. I noticed that I missed one snowflake right here, so I'm gonna actually add that in real quick. So all I have to do in order to do that is go to Animation Pane, Animation Painter, and then I can select this one right here. And now it's added back in. And again, now it's snowing and this looks so nice. It's super easy to do. I just had to add three animations to one snowflake, use the Animation Painter tool to click on all the different snowflakes. They all now come in a nice circle. It looks nice and clean. And I honestly am really engaged with this slide. I could add some text in this upper right here, maybe the title of my slide and some subtitle text, and then I'm good to go for this slide. And I can add this style to all the future slides I'm creating as well for this, or just the first slide as well. All right, so that is how you can easily animate snowflakes in PowerPoint for the holiday seasons. If you do want to access this template, I'll have a link to it in the description below. Also, if you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. It's free to do, so please do that. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy available, so I'll link to that as well in the description. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great holiday season, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.